You know, the one reason I could be openly, publicly optimistic about 2021 in terms of the real estate market is because, number one, it's what I believe, but number two, I don't care if it crashes.
This is what I believe. I'm sharing that with you for nothing. Just get out there and succeed.
What are your thoughts on the market crashing here in the next few, not crashing based on, because I think we're about to hit a year mark from COVID. And obviously the loan forbearances, et cetera, are about to become an issue. So do you think the market's about to tank in certain areas?
You mean like as far as stocks or real estate?
Real estate, yeah.
Yeah, I think tomorrow, I think next year is going to be great. I don't think that's, I think the government's going to have more assistance for the forbearance people, the people that are, you know, running into issues there. I think, I don't think the government's going to continue to help those people out and going to kind of smooth everything over. The thing is, man, is that the market has so much momentum right now. There's so much cash. And interest rates are so low, so nobody's spending their cash. They're borrowing money cheaper than they, you know, would cost them to buy cash. And so the cash is continuing to stay on the sideline. So as long as that cash is on the sideline the way it is, I mean, in massive amounts, there's so much cushion in the market. I mean, if the market comes down, there's so much cash that's going to get dumped into the market, which is going to make the market come back up. Supply and demand is a huge issue, right? There's very little supply, and nobody's really buying the speculation. Everybody that's buying is buying to live there. They're buying it long-term. You know, they're not buying it to sell it tomorrow, to sell it next year. They're buying it to live in it or keep it, you know, buy and hold and rent. Nobody has a strategy of selling next year, right? So if you do think, if you do think the market has a ways to go up, you're still not speculating that at this point because it's up so much, it's went up so much in the past 8 years that you're not speculating that it's going to go up anymore. You're not like, oh, okay, this is for sure. I want to put my money here. I'm going to sell it next year. No way. If it goes up, then great, but that's not what you're planning on. So I think we'll see a slight increase next year, man, overall, to be honest with you. I think we're going to have an amazing year. I think it's going to be a really, 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 really good year for real estate. You know, and the one reason I could be openly, publicly optimistic about 2021 in terms of the real estate market is because, number one, it's what I believe, but number two, I don't care if it crashes. You know what I mean? It doesn't affect me at all, man. Like, you know, my business is solid. You know, if it crashes, I have tons, hundreds of people that are ready to buy if the market goes down. If prices go down, I have so many. I mean, they would come out the woodworks. My phone would light up like a Christmas tree if the market crashed because people would want to get in, you know, so I would continue just crushing sales. And, you know, if the market crashes that hard and people are selling cheaper, there's going to be sellers that need to sell. And that's why I'm going to be right there to help them, you know. So regardless of what it does, I'm going to win big. So that's a good thing. That's what you want to be. You want to be in the position where it doesn't matter. It's a win-win. You can't lose. Yeah. That's where I am with stocks and my holdings. That's where I am with my real estate holdings. That's where I am in real estate business. I mean, I have a fortress set up, a foundation in place that doesn't matter what the market does. So I'm good either way, just to get that out in the air. But furthermore, I'm really optimistic on the market itself. I think we're going to have a hell of a year. So I know a lot of people are calling for gloom and doom. I know that there's I heard that the guy that was short, that shorted the market back when it crashed last time, is calling for another crash due to natural disasters causing insurance to go up, and plus your property taxes are going to go up because prices have went up. And so you have all these things that it doesn't matter if interest rates don't move or if interest rates are lower, your monthly payments are going to increase because your insurance is higher and your property taxes are higher. And I've heard that scenario, and I think that there could be a little merit to it, you know, but I just call bullshit. I mean, I just don't think it's going to cause this massive crash that's going to devastate us and we're going to see prices go down. You know, we may see a slight decrease in prices, you know. I just think we're going to see more of a flat, either a slight increase or a slight decrease. But at the end of the day, I think we're going to have a really, really good year, you know. You know, for real estate agents anyway, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, we make money regardless.